Today's story is Tallulah's Tutu.
Today's story is Tallulah's Tutu. Have you ever dreamt of being a ballerina? Well, let's read the story and see what Tallulah does. Enjoy the story. Let's start reading. And don't forget to subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. Let's get reading.
Tallulah just knew she could be a great ballerina if only she had a tutu and maybe a lesson or two, her mother said with a wink. So the next day, Tallulah went to her very first ballet class. The kids wore leotards and pink tights, all except one. He had on black pants. A boy in ballet? Well, he won't get a tutu, Tallulah giggled. Are you with us, Tallulah? Asked her teacher. Tallulah decided she better pay attention. She watched closely. She turned out her feet and curved her hands near her hips in first position. She bent her knees in a plié. She did it perfectly. I am an excellent ballerina, she thought, and soon I'll get a tutu. At the end of class, the teacher told them what a good job they'd done. Tallulah waited for her tutu, but instead she got a hug. Good job, her teacher said. Tallulah decided that her tutu must be coming from Paris. They would fly it in next week. Tallulah practiced every day. Look at my beautiful arms, she said on the way to class. Look at my perfect finish. She grinned a big grin as she stood at the bar. What color tutu do you want? She asked the girl in front of her. I want lavender. She pointed to some September asters blooming outside the window. Tallulah, look in the mirror. Can you make your back straighter? Her teacher said. Tallulah could. She jumped her heels apart to second position. She pointed her toe in a tendu. She circled her foot on the floor in a rond de jambe. I am a fabulous ballerina, Tallulah told herself. I'm going to get my tutu right after class. But this time, all she got was a kiss on the top of her head. Keep it up, Tallulah. You're doing well, said her teacher. Tallulah figured the delivery truck broke down. Her tutu must be stuck in New Jersey. They would drive it in next week. At home, Tallulah showed her mother everything she'd learned. Her little brother Beckett watched. Then she practiced some more. At her third lesson, she could hardly keep still. One, two, three. One, two, three. She sang to the boy next to her. A tunic for you, a tutu for me. She whirled around and bumped his leg. Tallulah, stay in your own space, please, her teacher said. Whoops, Tallulah said. She shifted one foot in front of the other in third position. She put one foot against her other knee in a passé. She did a relevé by standing on her toes. I'm the best ballerina in the world, Tallulah said to herself. Today I'll get my tutu for sure. But there was no tutu for Tallulah. No tutu at all. Where is it? She asked her teacher. Where is what? My tutu. Tallulah's teacher leaned down and put her arm around her. You have to wait a while, Tallulah. It takes time and a lot of patience to earn your tutu. Tallulah stumped her foot. It did not feel good to do that in a ballet slipper. That's not fair, she cried. A ballerina needs a tutu, and she needs it now. Tallulah decided she wasn't going to practice any more ballet. She told her mother that she wasn't going to show her any more steps, and she wasn't going to go to class ever again. Really? Said her mother. But I thought you loved ballet. I love ballet, said Beckett, even though he'd never taken a class. Well, I don't. I'm not even going to think about ballet anymore, Tallulah declared. But everything kept reminding Tallulah of ballet. Her neighbor's basset hound always stood in second position. The kitchen clock constantly performed rond de jambe. The serving spoon at dinner was forever doing tendus. And everywhere she went, Tallulah couldn't help dancing ballet. She always did a plié when she patted the neighbor's dog, and she couldn't go by a store window without doing a beautiful finish, or past a park bench without using it as a bar. Then, one day in the supermarket, she heard tinkly music over the loudspeakers. It was the same music the pianist played in her class. Tallulah couldn't stop herself. Passé, relevé, tendu. She did them all. She pirouetted around the store. When she finished, the shoppers applauded, except for one girl. She was wearing a lavender tattoo. I want to dance like that, she said. I've already got the tattoo. Maybe you need a lesson or two, or 22, Tallulah said, and lots of practice as well. She looked at her mother and winked. The next day, she went back to class. I'm glad to see you, Tallulah, said her teacher. Tallulah beamed. I'm glad to see you too, she said. Then she took her place at the bar. I am a very, very good dancer, she thought, and I will get my tutu someday. She did, except it wasn't lavender. It was as red as the roses blooming that June. The end.